हेलो एवरीवन, गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी टेक एंड डिस्कस अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट चैप्टर ऑफ योर सिलेबस. नाउ डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन टुडेज क्लास वी टेक एंड डिस्कस सम इंपॉर्टेंट कॉन्सेप्ट रिलेटेड टू योर लास्ट चैप्टर ऑफ योर एक्सरसाइज विच इज प्लेइंग विद नंबर्स. डियर स्टूडेंट, दिस इज वन ऑफ द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट chapter of your syllabus. So please dear friends, concentrate on this chapter. So because of hearing that chapter, we discuss about the some concept related to the numbers. So now let us consider, first of all we take the topic of your chapter, numbers in their general form. We are going to discuss about the numbers in general form. Numbers in general form. Okay, dear students, what is the concept of that chapter, dear students? First of all, this is the big question. What is the concept behind that topic? Look. So numbers in general form, suppose that we write any two digit number like as 45. So first we are going to generalize that number. Generalize means we just write in expanded form. So look, here we can write 45 in the form of, this is 5 is your unit digit number, this is your unit digit now, and this is 4 is your 10 digit. So we can write 45 as 4 into 10 plus 1 into 5, means only 5 we can write. So we can write in this way, means in it, because of the coefficient here, the coefficient of unit digit number is 1, because of here unit digit is 5, so there the coefficient of 5 is what, always say 1. And the coefficient of 4 is what, 10, because of this is the 10th place number. And dear friend, the 10th place number is always equal to, the coefficient of 10th place number is taken as 10 always. It is taken as 10 always. Okay, dear friends, so here, this is the very important concept related to that topic. Now, look dear friends, similarly if we write 678 in any three digit numbers, if we generalize them, so here the unit digit is 8, 10 digit be what, 7, and 6 digit be what, 6. So what I do dear friends for that, now look, so we can write, so we can write the given number is, here this is unit digit, so the coefficient of 8 is 1, so we only write 8, plus this is the 7, so the coefficient of 7 is 10, so 10 into 7, this is 100 digit is what, 6, so the coefficient of 6 is what, 100. So we can write in this way, so any 3 digit number we can write in this way. And here we can write 1 into 5, here number into 8. Similarly, any 4 digit numbers, in any 4 digit number we can expand or generalize form. The generalized form of the given number is what? 1, 1s, 10s, 100s, and 1000s. So the here 1000 place, in 1000 place there is 5, so here we must be, we can write 1000 into 5, plus this is the 100 place digit, this is 4, so its coefficient we take in as 4. Okay, so plus its 10 digit is 6, so we can write 10 into 6 and 1 into 9, because of its 1's place is 1 and then the 1's place is 9. So in this way, so we can expand, we can generalize the 2 digit, 3 digit and 4 digit numbers in this way. So according to that rule, we find what? According to that concept, we find if we have any number in this way. Look, if we have any number AB, then its generalized form we can write 10 into A plus 1 into 1, never we write 1 into B, 10A plus B. 10A plus B. This is the generalized form of the given number. Similarly, if we have ABC in any 3-digit numbers, so the generalized form of the 3-digit number is what? We can write 100 into A plus 10 into B plus C. Means we can write here, we can write 10A plus B. Here we write 100A plus 10B. Here we can write 1 into C. Plus C. So this is one. This is one. Very important. This is also a very important concept of that questions. Okay. Now, okay, look, similarly, if any 4-digit number is written in this way, then its generalized form is what? Then its generalized form is what? 1000 into A plus 100 into B plus 10 into C plus 1 into D. 1 into D. Okay. Now, we can write in this way. 200A plus 100B plus 10C and plus only D. Okay, so in this way, you can generalize and expand any 2, 3 or 4 digit numbers in this way using that concept. So this is a very important concept of that chapter. So please, dear friend, please concentrate on this topic. And in this way, you can solve each and every questions of your NCERT exercise based on these topics. Okay. Now we are going to discuss some other important concepts. If we take a very important question, look, if we write the following numbers in generalized form, the question is write the following numbers in generalized first part of the question is what? And second word 3329. Look, this is the question here. We just write the following numbers in generalized form. So what is the process? Let's see. Just I discuss about that concept. This is 73, okay? This is 73. Now look, so we can expand we can write, we generalize them. So they are here, the student, the unit digit is, the given number is 3 and the 10th digit of the given number is 7. Okay, now what I do, look, we can write 10 into 7 because of the unit digit, 10 digit is 7, so the coefficient of 7 we take as 10 always, plus we take as 1 into 3. So we can write 73 in this way. This is the generalized form of the given number. Similarly, dear students, this is the required answer. Okay, now we can solve. Similarly, we can solve the second part of this question, which is 329. Dear friends, in that question, look, in that question, its unit digit is 9, 10 digit is 2, 100 digit is 3. So we can generalize also. Look, what is the process to generalize that number? Look, so we can write unit 10, 100. So the quotient of 3 is 100. So 100 into 3. Okay. Here 10 digit is what? 2. So we can write 10 into 2 plus. And here 9. This is the unit digit. And 1 into. Because of the quotient of unit digit is always taken as 1. This is the required solution of the given number. Okay. In this way, dear student, you can solve each and every questions of your NCERT size based on this topic. This is one of the most important questions of your syllabus. Now, we take and solve some other important questions based on this topic. Now your question is, write the following in the usual form. Write the following in usual form. Write the following in usual form. First part of this question is what?
Plus 6.
Second part of this question is what? 100
into 7 plus
10 into 1
plus 8,
and last part of this question, 100 into 8 plus
110 into C.
Now let's see its solution. First of all, we take first part of this question. Look, first of all, we have the word.
This is 10 into 5 plus 6.
Look, there's a 10 into 5. So we, this is in generalized form, so we just write in usual form. It means in two digit, this is the two digit number because of the second digit. Only 10 is there, the unit digit is the quotient of 10, so 10 into 5, that is 50
plus 6, so we can write as 56. So this is one is the right answer.
So 56 is the required number in usual form. In usual form, this one. So in this way, you can write any number in usual form in this way. Similarly,
second one is 100 into 7 plus 10 into 1 plus 8 is equal to what? Look.
Hundred into seven, that is the 10 space digit, because of the coefficient of 7 is 100. So in that, in this number, this is, there are three digits.
So here this is 700 plus 10 1, this is 10 plus 8.
We now we adding them, so we get what? 718.
This is the
usual form of the given number. This is the usual form of the given number, dear friends. Now, third part of this question, third and last part of this question is what? Look,
this is 100 into A plus 10 into C plus D.
This is the number in variable form, so we can write 100 is what? 100 A plus 10 into C, that is 10 C plus B. This is the
required. So in this way we can write A C B. This is the usual form of the number.
This is the usual form of the number. ACB we can write here. Look, the coefficient of A is what? 100, because of, this is the 100th place digit. The coefficient of C is what? 10. This is the 10th place digit. And the coefficient of B is what? 1. That is the 1st place digit.
So this is the required
solution of the given number. So in this way, you can solve each and every questions of your NCERT exercise based on this topic. So please, dear students, do more and more practices of that type number. This is a very important concept. Please, do more and more practices of that type of questions. Okay. Dear students, any two digit number is the
any two digit number, so we can write in this way 100 into A plus 1 into B. So this is 10A plus B. This is the required form of any two digit numbers.
If we write anywhere, if the we find the number obtained by interchanging its digits,
means number formed by interchanging its digits,
then means that is B into A. So any number is obtained by the concept of interchanging
its digits. It means we can write 10 into B plus 1 into A means 10B plus A.
So in this way you clear the concept of that topic. Okay, dear students. So dear students, in this way, in today's class, we take and discuss some important topic related to the chapter playing with numbers. Now in next class we take and discuss some other important topic of that chapter. Okay, just now thanks to all.